So thank you for the opportunity and the attendees for your attention. So today I'm going to talk about sustainable silver and gold nanoparticles for the functionalization and electrocatalytic enhancement of the screen printed electrodes. So the agenda will be, first we're going to talk about a little bit the green synthesis of metallic nanoparticles, then a little briefing of metallic nanoparticles catalytic activity. Then I'm going to present the investigation objectives. We're going to talk about a little bit of the experimental methodology. Then I'm going to present the experimental results so far. And finally, the conclusions. So recently, nanoparticle synthesis using environmentally friendly methods has gained tremendous interest due to the use of non-harsh, non-toxic, and non-expensive chemicals. Biomaterials have been proved to have a critical role in the production of metallic nanoparticles, biomaterials such as bacteria, yeast, fungi, algae, plants. So these biomaterials, they can transform the metal ions into metal nanoparticles due to the reducing capability of the phytochemicals within, such as proteins, metabolites, sugars, flavonoids, polyphenols, etc. So in this slide, I want to show you a general schema of how metallic nanoparticles can be synthesized using green synthesis procedures. The first step is you need to choose what part of the plant you're gonna use to produce nanoparticles. You can choose between the stem, the fruits and vegetables, leaves, etc. So the next step will be a milling process. You can use, well, any crushing mill technique you want. So from this step, you are going to obtain a powder. So this powder is gonna be used to obtain an aqueous extract. After this aqueous extract is filtered to remove any impurity, you can mix with the precursor of the nanoparticle, a metal precursor, I mean, and this, once we have the dispersion of the nanoparticles of the chemicals, I mean the molecules of the biomaterials can reduce these metal ions and transform these in metal nanoparticles. After this, centrifugation process needs to be run. And here's an actual photo of how the nanoparticles are collected at the bottom of the tubes after the centrifugation. So once we remove the pellet of the bottom of the tube, you can perform any characterization or any test you want to with the nanoparticles. So now, why metallic nanoparticles have catalytic activity? As you may know, metallic nanoparticles have a large surface area to volume ratio compared to the bulk materials. This characteristic makes these materials attractive for catalytic applications. Recent advances in controlling the size and the shape of nanoparticles have proved to enhance the activity for specific reactions. For example, silver and gold nanoparticles have become increasingly popular in catalysis. I mean, when both nanoparticles are prepared at very small sizes and dispersed in a proper support, they can be a highly active catalyst in a wide range of reactions, such as oxidations, hydrogenations, and any related reaction. So for these reasons, we decided to modify screen printed electrodes with this, the silver and gold nanoparticles, because they can enhance the mass transfer rate at the electrocatalytic and the electrocatalytic activity of the electrode. So now, the investigation objectives basically are, first, the synthesis of silver and gold nanoparticles using grape stock waste tract, which is a residue from the wine industry, And then we're going to characterize them using a couple characterization techniques. Then we're going to perform the modification of the screen printed electrodes. And finally, we perform the voltammetric determination of lead using the modified electrodes. So if we take a look at the experimental methodology first, as I said, we perform the synthesis of metallic nanoparticles using the Grabstock waste tract, and we mix in a fixed volume with a metal precursor. In the case of silver nanoparticle was silver nitrate, and in the case of gold nanoparticles, chlorauric acid. So the Grabstock extract as the reducing and stabilizing agent. So once we had the nanoparticles, we performed the characterization using a scanning and transmission electron microscopy in order to obtain information about the size and the shape of nanoparticles. Then we also use a tracking analysis technique to obtain information about the particle concentration of the sample. So once we characterize the nanoparticles, we perform the screen printed electrodes modification using the spin coating method. That's basically place a total volume of 40 microliters into the surface electrode. So we divided this into cycles. So we place the electrode into the spin coater, which is the equipment you see on this side of the screen. And thanks to the centrifuge force, a uniform layer is created onto the surface electrode. Once we have the modified electrode, we perform a characterization using SEM. So regarding the voltammetric determination of lead, we use a differential pulse analytic stripping voltammetry. And with the analytical experimental parameters you see on the table, which are the deposition potential at this potential, the deposition time was 300 seconds, and the scanning potential was this range. The buffer acetic acid acetate, and we increase the concentration of lead from ICP standard from 1 to 90 micrograms per liter. So here I want to show you the electrochemical cell we use with the reference counter and working electrode, and it was connected to the potentiostat to perform the measurements. So now let's jump to the experimental results. First, I want to show you the characterization of the synthesized nanoparticles. On the left, you have the silver nanoparticles. You can see that it's a mix of shape. You have prism, round nanoparticles with a mean size of 27 nanometers. And then on the right, you have the gold nanoparticles. They were mostly round with a mean size of 36 nanometers. And with the NTA technique, we determined that the particle size was around, I'm sorry, with the particle concentration was these values. And as you can see for the gold nanoparticles, the concentration was higher. So here you have a nanotracking analysis video we recorded with this technique. And you can see the silver nanoparticles we synthesized, and these were the solutions looked like. So here I want to show you the SEM images of the modified electrode. On the left you have the silver modified electrode, the silver nanoparticles electrode, and you can see the particles encircled in the yellow circles. And on the right you have the gold nanoparticles modified electrode, and you can see also the particles encircled in the red circles. So with this technique, basically we determined that the proper attachment of the nanoparticles on the onto the surface electrode was occur. So regarding the voltammetric determination of lead, first I want to show you that we perform a test with the fixed concentration of lead, and we compare the signal between the bare electrode and the modified electrode. In this case, I want to show you the example with the silver nanoparticles, and you can see that we obtain an enhanced signal with the modified electrode. So in the particular case of lead determination, you can see here the stripping lead peak at that potential, and also the calibration plot that we obtain. As you can see, we confirm that the peak area was increasing as the lead concentration did, with a very good coefficient, relative coefficient value. Now with the gold nanoparticles, also the stripping peak you can see at the same potential, and the calibration plot also confirmed that the peak area was increasing as the concentration of lead was increasing. So with this table, I want to summarize the analytical parameters we obtain after we did the analysis with the data. And first, and basically, we have a similar performance of both electrodes. And first, the limit of detection was around 6 micrograms per liter and was a little bit low with the gold nanoparticles. You can see also the limit of quantification and the linear range. We also consider the lowest limit of the linear range as the corresponding limit of quantification, and very similar correlation coefficient values. And regarding the sensitivity, we can see that the gold nanoparticles was a little bit higher. We think that's due to the higher concentration of particles onto the surface electrode. So overall, this result can be a promising alternative to those sensors modified with metallic nanoparticles obtained by the conventional synthesis methods. So if we jump to the conclusions, first we can see that the green silver nanoparticles and gold nanoparticles were successfully synthesized using grape stock waste tract and characterized by STEM and ATA techniques. Also, the commercial screen printed electrodes were modified by the spin coating method using the synthesized nanoparticles and characterized them using SEM. The modified electrodes exhibit an enhanced electrochemical response compared to the bare electrode. And finally, the modified electrodes were tested for the lead voltammetric determination, obtaining detection limits around 6 micrograms per liter. So I would like to thank that this research has been funded by the Ministerio de Ciencia e Innovación with these projects, as well as by the Generalitat of Catalonia. So thank you for your attention. If you have any question, I will be pleased to answer them.
Yes.